The officials led by Henry Musasizi, the State Minister for Finance, and Sidronius Opolot Okasai, the State Minister for Energy, appeared before the Government Assurance Committee of Parliament, chaired by Joseph Sewungu, to brief Parliament on the progress to revamp the National Fuel Strategic Reserves in Jinja, which have been empty while the country is battling fuel scarcity and astronomical pump prices.
And colleagues, government is committed to the development of the Uganda oil refinery as a long-term solution to the persistent import vulnerability.
Musasizi told the committee that finance authorized UNOC to spend $12.9 million, approximately 49.2 billion shillings of savings from the forex gain of the East African crude oil pipeline, and reimbursement of historical costs to operationalize the fuel reserves, a stopgap measure before the elections.
Consequently, a total of 8 million liters of fuel were procured and currently stored at Jinja Storage Terminal. The resources arose out of the savings from the preparatory process of East African crude oil pipeline ECOP.
Did UNOC get $12 million to stock our JST?
Not directly disbursed Ministry of Finance, but when you're going to utilize the 12.9, you must get approval from Ministry of Finance.
The committee was surprised to learn that even the 8 million liters of fuel, which was procured and regarded as trading stock by Uganda National Oil Company and sold out to private oil companies for profit, including Stabex, leaving the country with empty reserves.
The money which is being discussed now was actually disbursed for trading stock to UNOC, because we wanted to have UNOC generating resources, not putting fuel on reserve. These are two different things.
Committee members fumed on learning that instead of stocking fuel reserves to cushion the fuel scarcity and escalating prices of fuel, money was channeled to UNOC's trading stocks as Ugandans battle price hikes of fuel.
Is government making business? Who is managing this fuel? Are we trading the fuel as a government? Well, no, Minister, you could assure us on that. That government is buying fuel and is selling fuel to make profits. But what we know is that there is UNOC, which is supposed to manage our stocks.
Do you want money in fuel, in stock, or in reserves?
But for us, we want reserves. Our interest is in reserves, and this issue of stock, trading stock, is being brought now. It's not a matter with us as a committee.
What is the difference between stock and reserves?
We've traded about 15 million liters with a net gain that is slightly under 2 billion.
So whom are you selling to? Which companies are you selling to?
Oil marketing companies around. No, we sell to Stabex.
Stabex, Shell.
We sell to.
So you want to say Stabex does not input its own fuel here?
It does, Mombasa. Because we can't allocate all the quota. We don't have all the money to distribute to them.
Okay.
UNOC needed 114.4 billion shillings to procure 22 million liters for fuel reserves to run the country for at least 10 days in case of an emergency. It is in this meeting that the State Minister for Finance, Henry Musasizi, disclosed that the country is currently financially constrained to stock its empty reserves.
We are saying we don't want to put money in the reserves, fuel in the reserves. But the problem is there is no money. Where do we get it from? You know the budget, you are the ones who pass it. I have not seen excess money in the budget. Whatever resource we realize, we appropriate it adequately here and there to ensure that we keep moving.
Musasizi also stunned committee members when he underestimated the significance of stocking fuel reserves, saying it is not proper to keep fuel idle in reserves because it can expire.
I'm told the 8 million liters also can take us for four to five days as we look around.
Our major interest, according to the promise and the assurance of government, is that we look at our reserves under UNOC, that there would be giving some relief on the cost of fuel if we had enough reserves.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.